Okay, so, before I start our presentation, I would like all of you, in an efficient manner, to try and go in the back, and there will be three plated cookies, and I just want you to pick which one is most appealing to you visually, and please do not account for the number of cookies on the stage, just what looks more appealing. So I'll give you a couple seconds, maybe more than 10, so go ahead.
Is it the, like, grass leaves?
Yeah, it's the garnish. And why I chose this picture in particular is because it has all the components of composition, which is the colors in the tomato, the three rule, and the asymmetry. Okay, ballot. So right here is all this space, and this is called negative space, and it's used to frame your food, just to like focus it on your actual food here. So negative space is really important to your life. Here, I like this picture. This is actually from Trueland Burger. I've been here. And you can see that they use the three rules. And they also utilize the negative space. But they're balanced here because the burger is heavy, and that's the focal point. But then they use a lighter slice of pickles. So that's why I like that. Another thing to think about when incorporating balance is you can change the focus of your plate. So when you think of chocolate cake, usually think of chocolate cake in the center, but right here they're utilizing all the ingredients to change the focus of the plate. Okay, next is shape. So can anyone tell me what shape they see the most in this plate?
Round.
Yeah, round, circle. So I don't know if it was me, but like the onions caught my eye the first time, and you can see that the shape matches with the droplets and the whole setup and the range of the food. So even the vegetables are in the center, the meat is kind of like circular looking, and the onions are too. So shape is really important when plating. Next we have here some vegetables. Now you might say, Gabby, that rice is round and that's a, you know, square plate. Like what the heck? As you can see, the vegetables here are sharp, and it's more sharp angled, and how it's laid out is kind of square, so therefore you would go on a square plate. Oops. And right here, I believe this is a lava cake, I don't know, but most of the cakes that I looked up that were like this, were 90% of them were on circle plates. And this is important because when preparing your food and plating it, you need to have to consider the shape of your food and the shape of the plate, so they kind of go together. Okay, so right here, we're going to talk about texture. The reason why I like this picture in particular was because you can see the texture of the cauliflower, mushrooms, and bread. And over here, what's also utilized in texture is creaminess, crunchiness, and smoothness. So I thought this picture did a great job representing those things. Here we have a bread, which is all about texture. But what I like most about this picture is the garnish kind of shadows the texture, which is, it was just nicely done. And right here, you can see that this dish focal point was all about texture. They had no negative space, like, at all. But that's okay, because when plating, you could just say, I want my plate to be about texture. Okay, so to recap, what are the key elements of plating? I'll just take some of you. So what's one element of plating that we just went over? The shape? Yeah. Composition. Okay.
Composition.
Anyone else want
to? Texture.
Yep.
Balance.
Yep. All right, so you guys were right. Ooh, 100%. Okay, so things to remember in composition is the layout, odd numbers, complementary colors, and I forgot to add this, but this is very important. Don't add color for the sake of color. One really great example of this is a chef to table. When a chef utilized one ingredient, which was all the same color, but they utilized texture to showcase that plate. Next is balance. You need to think of proportions, portions, and change the focus of your dish. You could also use negative space. Shape, take into account the plate of food, the actual food itself on the plate, and the plate shape. And less is more most of the time, because you don't want it overcrowded. Texture is where you get to play with your food. Don't be afraid. And remember to keep soft things like vegetable leaves or liquids or purees at the bottom. And remember when to use a garnish, because I wouldn't garnish my cereal, that's just weird. Okay, plating approaches, very quickly. We have the classic approach, which has the clock rule, where you have your meat, starches, and vegetables, and it's all centered out with the classic light plate. Here we have the linear approach, but what I like about this is that it's rounded, but it follows the shape of the plate, and it's still linear, and we can see all the food items are lined up. And secondly, we have the what's also called the free landscape approach, which is more artsy, and it utilizes the black plate instead of the classic light. And that is it for my presentation, but before I end, can anyone tell me how they could possibly use plating in their everyday lives?
I got a niece and a nephew that are really young, and they don't like eating a lot of the time, and so I feel like if I could find a way to, I don't know, plate it differently so they, it like enthuses them a little bit more, they'll eat it better.
That's awesome. And have you ever guys just like had takeout and decided to put it on a plate? No? Well, I've been doing that usually because I get a lot of my food kind of wrapped, and I just feel a lot better when it's presented on a plate. And also, when you're thinking about plating a